Dear students, in this video we are studying about the four dynasties in the Delhi Sultanate. In the last video we studied about the important rulers of the slave dynasty. It is also known as the Mamluk dynasty. The other four dynasties like the Khalji dynasty, the Tughlaq dynasty, the Sayyid dynasty and the Lodi dynasty, these four dynasties and the able rulers in these dynasties we are going to study in this video. Students, Jalaluddin Firoz established the Khalji dynasty in the year 1290 AD. The most important ruler of this dynasty was Alauddin Khilji. Alauddin established a vast empire. His conquest of Gujarat gave him access to its ports and overseas trade. Alauddin also conquered Malwa and parts of Rajasthan. According to a legend, he attacked the Chittor fort of Mewar to capture the beautiful queen Padmini. She was famous for her beauty. She was the wife of Rana Ratan Singh of Mewar. Alauddin sent his commander Malik Kafur to bring the rich kingdoms of the Deccan under his control. Malik Kafur went and there was treaty between the kingdoms of South India in the Deccan, like the Yadavas of Devagiri, Kakatiyas of Warangal, Hoslas of Dwarasamudra and Pandyas of Madurai. These kingdoms accepted the overlordship of Alauddin Khilji. Alauddin Khilji, his brief period of reign, almost the whole India was under his control, and with Malik Kafur as the regent, that means his deputy. The Tughlaq dynasty, after the Khalji dynasty, then the Tughlaq dynasty came into power in the Delhi Sultanate from the year 1320 AD to 1412 AD. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the founder of the Tughlaq dynasty in the year 1320. He died in 1325 and was succeeded by his son Jonah Khan, who took the title Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So Tughlaq dynasty was founded by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq in the year 1320 AD. After 5 years he died and he was succeeded by his son Jonah Khan. He accumulated the title Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He laid stress on merit and raised many people of humble origins to high positions. This offended many of the nobles present in his court. If ordinary people come into great powers or posts, that was angered the nobles, other important persons present in his court. Muhammad bin Tughlaq made grand plans and introduced many new policies, but these were not carried out properly. These failed experiments lowered his prestige. Revolts broke in many parts of his empire and provinces began to break away from the Sultanate. So Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he introduced many of the reforms of administration, but the nobles and other important officials not cooperated with him properly. That's why these experiments failed and his prestige was reduced. Then He died in the year 1351 AD. After the death of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, his cousin Firoz Shah Tughlaq ascended the throne. Firoz Shah Tughlaq ascended the throne. Firoz could neither suppress the revolts nor win back the provinces that had broken away. So he will not join back the territories that was broken away from the Sultanate. He promoted agriculture, trade and crafts, built many new towns and patronized learning. After Firoz's death in 1388, the Sultanate was rapidly declined. That means two famous rulers in the Tughlaq dynasty, Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Firoz Shah Tughlaq, they were not strict rulers. Then, rise of new kingdoms. From Muhammad bin Tughlaq's reign onwards, several provinces became independent kingdoms. Then, among the independent kingdoms were the Vijayanagar and Bahmani kingdoms of the Deccan. There were kingdoms of Bengal, Jaunpur, Gujarat, Mewar, Marwar, Kashmir and Assam. These kingdoms became independent. They were separated from the Sultanate. Then after Firoz Shah Tughlaq, a warrior, he was from the ruler of the region around Samarkand in Central Asia. He was called Taimur Lang. That means Taimur the Lame. He was a disabled person, believed to be a disabled person. He occupied some territories in the northwest. He then plundered Delhi. He invaded India in the year 1398 AD. Taimur Lang, that is, he was a disabled person. He was a warrior from Central Asia. He was ruling a region around Samarkand. And he looted the wealth of Delhi and took away to Samarkand. He plundered many more cities. He carried away enormous wealth. He also took the skilled artisans from India to work on monuments in Samarkand. Taimur left an Afghan chief named Khisar Khan in charge of his Indian territories. One general or an Afghan chief called Khisar Khan was in charge of the Indian territories that were occupied by Taimur when Taimur went back to Samarkand. The Tughlaqs could not recover their power and they declined after the Taimur's invasions. Khisar Khan started the Sayyid dynasty. He occupied the Delhi and made it his capital. In the year 1414 AD, and he established the Sayyid dynasty, and the Sayyid dynasty ended in the year 1451 AD. For many years, the Sayyid dynasty ruled. So that was under Khisar Khan. He was a general of Taimur. When Taimur went back to Samarkand, he became the ruler of Delhi. Then students, the Lodi dynasty. Now we are going to study about the Lodi dynasty. The Lodis were Afghan tribesmen. Many of them had entered India during Muhammad bin Tughlaq's reign. In 1451, Bahlul Lodi founded the Lodi dynasty. In 1489, he was succeeded by his able son Sikandar Lodi. So, The Lodi dynasty was founded by Bahlul Lodi. When the Sayyid dynasty was declined, actually they came to India during the Tughlaq dynasty, but they were not become powerful. But when the Sayyid dynasty, their power declined, they started to rule many territories, and it was founded. This dynasty was founded by Bahlul Lodi in the year 1451 AD. He was succeeded by his son Sikandar Lodi after his death in the year 1489 AD. Sikandar was a just ruler and a patron of arts and learning. He founded the city of Agra, which he made his capital. He made Agra as his capital. He died in the year. Sikandar Lodi died in the year 1517 and was succeeded by his son Ibrahim Lodi. Sikandar Lodi was succeeded by his son Ibrahim Lodi in 1526. After 9 years after the death of Sikandar Lodi, Ibrahim Lodi became the ruler of the Delhi Sultanate. He made Agra, their capital was Agra. At the time of Sikandar Lodi, they made Agra as their capital, a place near, not much distant from Delhi. And in 1517, Ibrahim Lodi became the ruler. And in 1526, the Central Asian chief Babur invaded India. Babur invaded India. He defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the first battle of Panipat in the year 1526. First battle of Panipat was between Ibrahim Lodi and Babur, and there was the second battle of Panipat between the general Bairam Khan, the general of the great Mughal Akbar, and between the Hemu, the present ruler at that time, Hemu. That was the second battle of Panipat. After the first battle of Panipat, Ibrahim Lodi was defeated and the Lodi dynasty came to an end, together with the Sultanate. Delhi Sultanate also came to an end. So this is the picture of Ibrahim Lodi, Sultan Ibrahim Lodi. So students, we studied about many sultans in the Khalji dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty, the Sayyid dynasty, and Lodi dynasty in this video. I hope you understood. Thank you.